And as the United Nations General Assembly gets underway in New York, world leaders agree on a declaration to fast-track meeting the UN's Sustainable Development Goals. More in this report.
On a rainy day in New York City, a somber reminder at the United Nations General Assembly of how world leaders are behind schedule in meeting the 17 Sustainable Development Goals they adopted in 2015 and hoped to achieve by 2030.
Despite commitments to eradicate poverty and to reduce hunger being at the core of this agenda, alarmingly, 1.2 billion people were still living in multidimensional poverty as of 2022. It is estimated that approximately 8% of global population, or 680 million people, will still be facing hunger in 2030.
Young leaders also raised concerns about the lack of progress toward the Sustainable Development Goals, or SDGs, demanding action to combat climate change and concrete solutions to empower their generation.
68 million young people are looking for jobs all over the world. Millions of young people are unable to access social protection coverage. Mental health problems like depression and anxiety are a serious concern for young people.
World leaders did manage to adopt on Monday a political declaration that brings a ray of hope to struggling economies.
This includes clear support for an SDG stimulus of at least $500 billion a year, as well as an effective debt relief mechanism that supports payment suspensions, longer lending terms, and lower rates.
Guterres said countries can help get the SDGs back on track by paying attention to six targeted areas, including relieving hunger, ensuring gender equality, and improving education.
Our proposed Global Digital Compact will also help countries build safe digital systems that provide internet access for all, including students in hard-to-reach communities.
Guterres highlighted another initiative that aims to create 400 million new jobs, especially in the green, care, and digital sectors. He also emphasized that countries must act now to rescue the SDGs. Verónica Valderas Iglesias, VOA News, the United Nations.
Turkish President Tayyip Erdogan stepping in to save the Ukraine grain deal and bring back Russia to the negotiating table. This report.
The United Nations General Assembly is the venue for Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan's latest bid to save the Ukrainian grain export deal after Russia's withdrawal from it. Erdogan, who has close ties with Russia's Vladimir Putin, brokered the grain deal last year with UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres.
It's a positive role that Turkey is playing, acknowledged by all actors, and also it in a way justifies Turkey's balancing act, because if Turkey had suspended political dialogue with Russia, Erdogan wouldn't be able to play this role. So in a way, it also mutes criticisms towards Turkey's balancing act.
Erdogan met with Putin earlier this month and said he would present proposals at the UN to revive the deal. The Turkish leader has voiced sympathy for Moscow's call for the easing of sanctions to allow the Russian export of grain and the lifting of financial controls to allow grain payments.
Understandably, Western countries are wary of giving what Putin wants immediately. The grain deal is Putin's leverage against what we could call the economic weapon against Russia.
Erdogan's close ties to Putin have strained his relations with Washington, which will complicate the Turkish leader's efforts to persuade U.S. President Joe Biden to make concessions. Observers say Erdogan will be looking for support from U.N. Secretary General Guterres.
We know the relationship between President Erdogan and President Biden is not excellent. Let me put it that way. And obviously he knows, Erdogan knows, that he cannot convince by himself or by Turkey itself the United States to move. So I think he's going to try to bring in the United Nations into the picture, so to kind of convince Biden to make a move towards Russia.
Erdogan's diplomatic efforts come as Ukraine starts to export grain in the face of Russian threats, raising the danger of an escalation in the Ukrainian war.
Russia intentionally might try to block them and might create escalate the situation. Then you don't know what it will happen. I mean, it can spill over anywhere and everywhere. It might spill over into Turkey or other Black Sea countries. And currently, of course, the conflict is contained.
For Erdogan, observers say saving the grain deal will not only avert the risk of famine and soaring food prices, but will help silence critics of his ties to Putin and reduce the danger of an escalation in the Ukrainian conflict. Dorian Jones for VOA News, Istanbul.
A U.S.-based think tank raises financial red flags on San Miguel Global Power's fossil fuel expansion. The Institute for Energy Economics and Financial Analysis says volatile fossil fuel prices make the company's expansion of coal and natural gas-fired power capacity susceptible to financial issues. The think tank added the company's shift from coal to LNG could worsen the situation, noting LNG is a more expensive fuel and is expected to remain costly. The wholly owned subsidiary of San Miguel Corporation is the largest power producer in the Philippines. It controls 4,719 megawatts of operational power capacity.
The Philippine finance chief bucks calls to suspend the excise taxes on fuel. Secretary Benjamin Diokno warns government could lose billions of pesos in revenues and could also put at risk funding for its programs. Diokno adds a suspension on fuel taxes could negatively affect the country's debt and credit ratings.
Ang ibig sabihin yan, kung hindi natin babawasan yung spending dahil mawalan ng revenues at tuloy-tuloy yung pag-gastos natin, lalaki yung deficit mo, di ba? Lalaki yun from 6.1 magiging 6.4 ang deficit mo, percent of GDP. Pag lumaki yun, lalaki rin yung utang mo. Lalaki rin yung utang mo eh, kasi mangungutang ka para tustusan yung kawalan ng revenues. From 61.4% of GDP magiging 61.7%. Ang mangyayari niyan, mawawalan ng kumpiyansa yung, di ba, yung mga credit rating natin. Right now, kaganda-ganda nga ng credit rating natin, investment grade, no? Pagka nawalan yung ano yan, matataas ang interest ng panghihiram natin as a government.
Oil futures hit their highest levels in a year on more concerns of a supply deficit. West Texas futures were up nearly $92 per barrel on Tuesday, while Brent crude futures were higher by as much as $95 also per barrel. Reuters reports global oil prices remain on track for their biggest quarterly decreases or increases since Russia's invasion of Ukraine in 2022. The continuing price hikes also comes after Saudi Arabia and Russia extended their voluntary supply cuts until the end of the year. The Philippine House Speaker says they could recommend the suspension of the excise tax on fuel products to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. if oil prices continue to climb. Romualdez made that statement following a meeting with oil players on Monday. He also told oil companies to help curb domestic fuel costs by cutting their profit margins.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., the president spoke Tuesday at the distribution of seized smuggled rice in Zamboanga province. He says the price cap would help the public afford the staple commodity amid soaring costs, which he attributed to the El Nino phenomenon. According to Marcos, who is concurrently the agriculture secretary, different countries in Asia, such as China, Singapore, Thailand, and Indonesia, were already racing to have enough buffer stock before the dry spell, causing a spike in rice prices.
Lahat bumibili. Kaya sabay-sabay silang bumibili, sabay-sabay pang din ang, sumasabay din ang pag-akyat ng bigas. Kaya kailangan natin lagyan nga ng price cap. At lagi kong pinapaalala sa lahat ng mga kasamahan ko, hindi lamang na kailangan na may sapat na pagkain ay kailangan may presyo na kayang bilhin ng taong bayan, unang-una. Pangalawa, na may magandang hanap buhay naman ang mga magsasaka. Kaya yan ang tinitiyak natin.
Several Southeast Asian companies considering listing in the U.S., banking on strong investor appetite for emerging market growth in the absence of Chinese stock offerings. Those include digital financing platform Funding Societies, Singapore-based entertainment firm Gush Cloud, and Thai insurance tech firm Sunday. These companies told Reuters they were looking into New York as one of their IPO venues. That's on top of the IPO plans of Vietnamese internet company VNG Corp and Philippine real estate firm Double Dragon's Hotel 101 Global. Southeast Asian firms have raised about $101 million via public offerings in the U.S. so far this year. Bankers expect the pace to pick up over the next 12 months as companies hunt for new sources of capital after relying on private firms for the last few years. Regional equities deepened their losses on Tuesday as the big decision day for the U.S. Federal Reserve nears. Asian investors are also digesting the latest minutes from Australia's central bank. The RBA in its September 5 meeting said Australian inflation remains too high and signaled that further policy tightening may be required. Looking at major stock indices now, the Nikkei 225 shedding nearly 0.9%, even amid reports the Bank of Japan will likely keep its interest rates unchanged this Friday. The ASX 200 also in the red following the release of the RBA's minutes. Let's take a look now at futures in Europe. They are pointing to a lower open for markets in the region as traders remain cautious ahead of major monetary policy decisions, including from the Bank of England. August inflation data from the Eurozone due out in the next hour. Stateside now, futures are pointing to a lower open as well as investors buckle up for the Fed meeting.